Don't Live Here Now is kind of interesting because I started that song, you know, like maybe 10 years ago, maybe even longer. I started the chord progression. I remember exactly where I was. I was sitting on a bed in a condo in New York, playing my guitar. I had the capo on, maybe the fifth fret. It was super high, and I was strumming. If I don't leave here now. And I had kind of that. And then I lowered the key and kept sort of working on the song as the years went by, not a lot. But then when I sat down to write this group of songs, I revisited it. It was in the list of contenders for this record, and then, but it wasn't quite, it didn't really strike anybody particularly, you know, it wasn't like, oh, that's a keeper, we gotta have that. But then Jordan had the idea to turn it into a ballad. She said, she completely slowed down the tempo and wrote this little part for it and then represented it. And then it was like, we have to have this on the record now. And it was really, who knew?
And when it hits the papers, the tongues start wagging like it can't be happening.
You know what? I don't have it in me. My voice is tired. What, you don't agree? It's a song that means a lot to me, and when we went to record it, usually I like to overdub, so I like to play a song, we'll get the track, I'll maybe play guitar, then I'll sing my vocals and we'll put it together. But Jordan's like, just try playing this and singing it with the guitar. I didn't have any headphones on and I just sang it in a room. And I was in a bad mood, I didn't feel good, I felt like maybe I was coming down with something. I think it was towards the end of the day, I was crabby. I said to Jordan, I don't know if I'm coming down with something, my throat feels scratchy, I'm mad. I don't want to do this. I don't think I can do this. And she said, well, just try it one more time. And so really I did it for her.
Don't give up yet.
Okay, I won't give up yet.
I appreciate that.
No problem.
Pull up your britches.
That's it. Take a deep breath. Pull up your britches. Before I recorded it, I wouldn't have gone intellectually, I'm mad and I feel like crap and this is a song about addiction and it's really heavy and so this should be perfect. Let's do it. You know, it was more like, I don't feel like it. But of course it does make perfect sense. And that's part of the mystery that just happens in recording and with music and with members of your team and your friends who can push you through something to get to the other side.
You are rolling.
Here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Say if it ever was, it's still in there. You can dig and fill, and never will be full. Trying to get that good again. Your last fifth of Jack, a cigarette, the time you bet the farm before you lost it all. You want that feeling. Back you go against the wind and killing yourself to stop from running out of time. But if I don't leave here now, I will never get out of this place. Baby, believe me now, there's no dragon to chase. Even looking at your face in front of me, if there was ever one, there could be two. You and you and you, a blue sky could be bluer, a whiter shade of white. While you pour it on, you pour it out, you empty everything you might have saved instead. Back you go against the wind and good advice, killing yourself to stop from running out of life. chase. Even looking at your face. When it hits the papers, the tongues start wagging. Like it can't be happening. Doctors take it and they take it away. And when they do, you'll find your stand-up every man goes looking for his heroin. It happens every day, around every bend, again and again. If I don't leave it now, I will never get out of this place. Baby, believe me now, there's no dragon to chase, even looking at.